Welcome to the Didi and Lital Show. Advice, thoughts, and stories from a married couple on cybersecurity, technology, and life in general. Now here are your hosts, Didi and Lital.
Hello, and welcome to the Didi and Lital Show. It's another week. How are you doing, Didi?
I'm doing awesome. You know why?
Why?
Because the Montreal Canadiens suck, and they lost last night. This is going for you, Sam. As you know, Sam is a big Canadiens fan.
Yeah.
The fact that they still insist that the coach speak French, F them. So, they can stick it in their derriere.
Okay. Fine.
Yes.
What else?
What else?
Nothing else?
Spring has sprung. I think eventually we will have to have Apple TV because I'll have to watch The Dynasty because I'm hearing that everybody throwing Bill under the bus and I want to be there with pompons to cheer. So that's...
It won't be available anywhere else? Because we're not in Apple TV. Just get it for that?
You'll get it for that and cancel it like 5 minutes. But probably we can
like
do it like...
Everything else.
Like everything else.
Yeah. We have a topic that I think is kind of like top of mind for everyone.
Yes. Yes. AI is going after your job. This is the fact.
So I have some time recently, and I wanted to see how fast it takes you now to put a digital business using AI. And it was amazing, shocking. So basically, I kind of like wanted to see how fast I would spin a logo, a website, and some messaging to a new company. So a little bit of prompt on ChatGPT, using Wix's new AI tools to build and design a website.
Yep.
And another kind of Canva-like, but not Canva, tool for generating logo for a new business. It cost me about $300. You know, the GoDaddy domain. GoDaddy has an AI tool that helps you find an available domain and that like is with a prompt of
Can you do that for the podcast? Because we still don't have a website.
We have a website. We didn't launch it. That's like because we're lazy. Actually, we outsourced it to Omri, which is worse than outsourcing to AI.
Yes.
So we do have. Let's launch it.
Yes.
So things aside, the point is less than three hours.
Like a SpaceX rocket.
Less than 3 hours of work, about $300 on, you know, domain, Wix subscription to get it without advertisement, and a full set of beautiful logos, you know, different colors, a full kind of design scheme. And I was up and running, still didn't launch, kind of like figuring that out. But the amazing thing was how easy it was, how the user experience was great. I was giving prompts of what's the business is all about, why, what I care about, and the template that I got was like good enough for me to go edit it, change it, and perfect it. But there was so much already built to start from, so I didn't need to use any consultant, any designer, graphic designer, web skills, which I have zero. Basically, it was all, you know, I didn't even need to drag and drop stuff. It already, the whole thing was
dropped.
Beautiful, dropped, created. All I needed is to change a little bit the text to my liking. Already took the SEO part, putting meta text. So that made me worried. Like, oh my God.
Why should he?
Because, you know, I used to run big marketing teams with great designers, copywriters, people that's their job to make beautiful websites, to make beautiful logos. And I do think that there's still a place for them, at least for the best of them, to maybe start with AI and then make it better, more artistic. But at the end of the day, a lot of those jobs are fast going away.
I don't think so.
I'll give you, before you get to your point, I'll give another thing that this company, I'm forgetting the name, that they provide credit when you buy something online, Klarna, they can kind of like cut it into sub-payments. They posted that they completely eliminated the tier one and tier two support, completely replacing it with AI chatbots and getting much better results, much better happiness scores from customers, and things were resolved much faster. So they kind of cut 700 jobs of support people. They still have the tier three, the escalation, the ones that give you empathy and take care of the unique problems that you have. And that's where people are really good at. But that's another job that it's going away faster than we can ever think of. It's not going to be even 2 years before customer support. I mean, it's already automated. It's going to be so good. And think about it. You can get it in your own, if you're calling, you can get it in your own language, you know, dialect. It's going to be so good. So yeah, there are a lot of jobs that are going away. Some will stay. And today I wanted to talk about if you have kids that are going to college, if you have kids that are in high school, and if you are yourself wondering about what's the future, what jobs will be AI-proof and will stay? How can we think of job security in this world that is very rapidly changing? I think that sales, marketing, customer support is just going to be completely redone, and very few of us will have a job.
Okay.
That's the reality. So it's a call for action for everyone. We need to face the reality. Our jobs are going away.
I disagree with you.
You think I'm still going to have a job?
Well, your job is a bullshit job, so we don't know. But
the AI will bullshit.
The AI will bullshit okay. instead. But this is the thing that we need to think about. So I'll give a live example of how I interview developers and the answers that the AI give. But I'll also explain how this is just an acceleration tool if you're smart. Producer Dave, we're drum roll.
You're going to
share.
Share your...
Because sharing is caring.
ChatGPT screen.
So Dennis was here a million years ago. And if you haven't listened to the Me and Dennis Love Fest here, go listen to that episode.
It's how you hire people.
Yes.
Basically.
So if you remember, Dennis and I said that we give people how to find bugs in a Java program that Dennis wrote. And this is the Java code that Dennis wrote, which is a piece of crap. Like real Dennis code. He didn't need to work really hard. And we told ChatGPT, hey, can you find bugs in this code? And the answer was really, really fast. It gave me 12 bugs that it found. It missed a couple of them. And by the way, this is the fun part about ChatGPT, because I gave the same question to it about 15 times, because I'm a nerd and I have nothing better to do in my life.
Did it get any better?
No, so
the results were different.
The results were different, which is a really cool and important part, because if I'm being...
It runs it from scratch every time.
It runs it from scratch. And I can also ask the impact. One of the things I really loved is, for example, this file not closed properly. I asked it, what did you do with that? And what should you do? And it gave me a code of example of how to fix it. But it also explained that it's not really a problem, because from Java certain version and on, it's more of a eyesore than an actual problem. In this run, by the way, you'll see that it missed one of my favorite bugs, because again, I'm a nerd, which is this one, the exit of -1 as a hard-coded one. because it's one of those phonetic things that explains that systemically, if somebody runs this command, it will have a problem. And I asked it about the array index out of bounds, what will it produce as an outcome, and it could explain this, which was really nice. It had a really nice, I had a very nice conversation with it. It's still not as good as, and by the way, it's by far not as good as Anton. Anton.
How many bugs?
There's about 18.
So Anton finds the entire 18.
Yeah, I actually found bugs that Dennis didn't know that were there, that we added. We have like a cheat sheet for this. He found a couple of bugs that Dennis didn't even know that were
so
there.
So Anton beats ChatGPT at the moment.
Yes. And
he is like Kasparov against IBM Deep Blue something at the time before yes. it beat it.
Yes.
I'm sure once Anton provides the prompt, ChatGPT will learn it, and that's it.
It could be. It could be not. But the thing is that it's an okay solution. This, by the way, my favorite question of the bubble sort one, which is, this is the part where I really am enjoying this. It does. I asked it to do my coding in line aspect. I've interviewed, since this came out, I've interviewed about 30 people. One person used Copilot. One. And it can do this. The fact that people are not thinking of using this is a
big... Maybe they're afraid that you'll find out.
I tell them, do whatever. They're cutting and pasting from Stack Overflow without understanding what they're cutting and pasting. If they actually use this tool, they might actually do a better job.
So if you want to get a job with Didi, use Copilot, ChatGPT.
If you don't use Copilot, I actually think poorly of you, because my expectation is that you will do your best. You will try your best.
So how do you know that there's people that can actually spot anything in the code if all they did is copy-paste from ChatGPT?
Well, this is the thing that you can add. This is the part where you need to have the interaction. And this is the part where ChatGPT is limited. And understanding what would be the impact on you. And this is the other part where I wanted to explain to you. So when I gave this code, this task, for a lady called Vanya to run the same code when she was interviewing with me a million years ago, she got the algorithm wrong. But she built a beautiful UI, and I was interviewing her as a UI developer. She created a very creative UI and understood what the actual task is. And this is where ChatGPT is limited. This is where the limit actually is, of understanding the tool usage for the fit. And now I'm going to reverse it back to the dawn of time, since there were dinosaurs. So Oleg and I now have built 5 cloud-based solutions. The first one he did without me, which was Sayora. The operation team size to run Sayora 3D Secure was insane. We had like a whole floor of people, and all they needed to deal, and they had contractors with NTT, because you needed to mount the Sun Solaris servers. We had to have my buddy Asaf tuning the database and futzing around with the database all the time. It was like a whole team around it. And it took forever to release a patch. It took us like 3 months to fix something fundamental. If when a big company, like a big US bank, joined us, it took us 9 months to onboard them. Terms of scaling.
Because you need to buy the servers and configure the servers.
Exactly.
That's the on-prem days.
That was hosted days. It's not even on-prem. On-prem would have taken even longer. Because
you need to fly and then install it over there.
Exactly. Yeah. So if you think about it, now when we delivered Oort, we did a lot more. We'd have a team of 7. So a team of 7 people.
Sure, because you don't care about the infrastructure.
Because AWS replaced.
Just put AWS on.
Exactly. But it didn't kill ops jobs. It just morphed them. You don't need the rackers and you don't need stackers. They need to work for Amazon.
How many people you have in ops versus what used to be.
Exactly. But you need to have.
You need to have a few smart ones that deal with that, but you shrunk the whole stack of people.
Yes. But it didn't shrink the industry. If you look at the industry,
the industry only grew
significantly. And there's still
there's going to be a ton of apps to build on top of AI.
And
people will need to configure the AI.
And there is a shortage right now of good SREs. If you try to find good SRE right now, you're actually at a problem. Even with the whole market, there's collapse, there's problems, there's finding a good SRE, good luck.
I think there is going to be a ton of new roles, like those prompt engineers. That's basically like UI UX people, like thinking about how to, instead of giving you picture of black people when you're asking for, you know, the father funders, actually design it that what you're asking the AI is going to be the right result.
You need to explain what you just said. You need to explain.
So go listen to an episode of The Daily about why Gemini by Google had those issues coming up of like not giving the right answers and giving weird, diverse answers. And the answer was at the end of the day that it's not necessary. It's about the training models, the data that was trained, but mostly about when you are asking, which is called the prompt, when you are kind of like writing, give me an image of the founding fathers of the US, the answer that comes back to the prompt might be altered. Maybe if it comes white, and Google wants to show diversity in the pictures that come out, because it used to be that you ask for, give me a businessman, and all the pictures came like white men, because that's what the internet has. And AI, as Didi always said, is basically statistics. It learns from the statistics, and most pictures when in on the internet of businessmen are white male. Yes. So if they want the results to be diverse, because that's what they thought people want to, they kind of tweaked the model
the question that what you ask for. They crafted
it add automatically the word diverse asking for that. It added diverse or something else into the prompt. So there are new forms of engineers that just understand what you ask for, add context, add some kind of like understanding potentially of what is it that you're looking for, and they make they adjust the answer, basically. So there is a new form of jobs that will be not just building the models, feeding the models, but actually the human interaction with the automated machine which is the new thing of UI UX in a way. What people want to get from the machine. So that's an interesting thing to think about how this is going to be evolving. It's also a new role of like QA, if you think about it, on the way back, like designing how the answer is going to look like. So that's interesting. There's going to be a lot of new jobs. My recommendation to all my kids was you have to take statistics in high school today. As we just mentioned, AI is statistics.
It's statistical inference at scale.
That's what LLM models are. So kids, the most important skill
thing to know
is know statistics. So I just said to all the kids, make sure you take statistics already in high school. You need to understand those concepts of probability, distribution. Just take it in high school. Very important. So that's for everyone. I think that's a basic skill today.
Or be a plumber. Because one thing is very, very clear. There's this book that you learn as a three-year-old that everybody shits, everybody poops. This is a fact.
Which book is it?
Everybody Poops. It's called Everybody Poops. Trust me.
I grew up in Israel.
Even Israel.
But it was like how you poop.
No.
It's for potty training?
It's for potty training. Okay. And there's a book, Everybody Poops. There's a Hebrew version of this. You have to trust. No. That's a
Naftali?
That's another one.
Okay.
So that when we grew up, we didn't plagiarize from the US and translated. But Everybody Poops is it's a big thing. It's like, it's like, are you my mom and things like that.
Okay.
Luckily, everybody poops. Even fish poop. They don't pee, but they do poop. And because of that, you'll always need somebody to unclog the drain. And I have yet to see an AI that takes an auger like I do. By the way, this is a couple of reasons that I will never be kicked out of the house. I will never be kicked out of the house because of three reasons. A, I am the one that opens the jars. Ron might replace me, but he does.
Ron opens the jars nowadays.
Yes, but I still open the jars. I still get things from the upper shelves. And now in the new house that we have 14 feet ceilings, trust me, Mr. Midget.
Worse,
Miss
yeah.
Midget, you're not getting to any of those shelves. So somebody to remove things from the upper shelves. And last but not least,
unclogging
the drain. Drains, exactly. I'm the only one that uses the auger without destroying the house. And that, Ron, fails miserably, by the way.
I actually tried it and I was successful.
Okay.
You were away and I did it. I'm very proud of myself. That's yes. One of the biggest achievements of my life.
But
calling a plumber. You're right. I mean, I think that's another thing. We may need to go back to basics because in some areas, knowledge workers might, I don't know if they're going away, but a lot of knowledge-based work, at least the basic of it, like think of paralegal. AI is great at that. I don't know if you will need paralegal or
yes,
that
you do.
Many of paralegals. Like you can go and do all the research work with AI. So again, it's not going to go away, but you will need less of those.
You still need somebody to carry the lawyer's bag.
Yeah, maybe there's going to be a robot. a little kind of...
No, the jokes aside,
I think a lot of... knowledge workers, knowledge positions are going to change. And there's still going to be, first, the people that will build the AI tools for that. But again, some are going to go away. That's the reality. I think that's the first time that we will see disruption. Like when you have the Industrial Revolution and, you know, a lot of manual labor was changed forever. That's the first time AI is actually taking away some of the knowledge worker. That's a disruption that is coming up. It's going to change. We don't know exactly how, but you need to assume that some roles will be going away. That's it. So,
but I think that this is where I think it's an improvement to the market.
I'm not judging. I don't think it's great.
I don't think the jobs will go away because. You need to measure the outcome. And if you need more of an outcome, the job is not going away. It's just getting morphed. I'll give you an example. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, designers only designed by hand. When freehand came in, everybody said, no, it's destroying. And Sketch, as a later version after freehand, because Sketch can also do a lot of the stuff for you.
And CAD and all this.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly. AutoCAD used to be the only way and you need to be an AutoCAD engineer. And then a lot of automated software came in and said, no, you don't need to do all the measuring. You don't need to do all these things. You don't need to do this thing by hand. You just take a couple of pictures and it knows the scale and knows the numbers and
It simplifies the work for you. The bar for entering a job is... lowered, which
or
is
higher,
great.
Or higher, because you need to know different skills. And this is where we need to understand that very much like freehand changed the way designers work, DALL-E will change the way designers work. When Wix came in and HubSpot and Shopify, they really changed the way that you deliver e-commerce, but it actually grew the industry.
Yeah, because every... mom and pop's shop can now go internationally.
It's also obviously. It's actually built a whole generation of contractors. There's people whose job, there's like a, if HubSpot has like 13,000 employees, I think there's about 300,000 people whose jobs is actually to configure HubSpot for you.
Yeah. Yeah. You will need less of that again. Now AI will help.
AI will do a million things, but it will not change the fact that sometimes you need somebody with a good eye to say, this design makes sense and this is not ugly. And this is where you're not understanding. When you do this thing, you can take a look at this and say, this doesn't look like IBM Blue of every other security company out there on the website. you can come in and say this logo is not offensive, it's not a problem, it's not...
Well, I think you can teach AI to be better than that. Like this specific knowledge that I have.
You need to know the question AI to ask. You need to know the question to
ask. Right. So a lot of us professionals will actually be used to build the AI, train the AI.
Yeah.
That's another thing. Like a knowledge could be used. How many of us do you need? I don't know. But yes, I have a lot of knowledge of what will work and what will not work. And maybe my knowledge can train the model. But my point is, when you are going today into school, into college, you do need to realize that there are certain things that will be changing. So learn skills and not necessarily learn a job. And do realize that the basics for sure will stay. People need to eat. People need a place to go and live in. So real estate, yes. Restaurants, yes. Food, yes.
Plumbing, because everybody poops.
Plumbing. So the basics, people will be sick. They'll need a doctor. AI will do some diagnostics.
If you are looking at doctors used to be revered. If you ask every Indian mom and every Jewish mom, they thought that being a doctor is like a godsend. Insurance, this is where people always fear the AI, but they don't understand that insurance and market strength actually kill doctors. Doctors used to make more than software developers. Today, software developers make, on average, a lot more. And everybody says, no, but I know these three surgeons, they make a shitload of money. And I said, yeah, every VP in Cisco makes more. So this is where I think doctors, no. It's a shitty job. It's really hard. You bear the brunt. You need to work with idiots because the majority of the population are idiots.
But you still need them.
And they're unwashed masses. You need them, but
they'll be there.
But
maybe they'll make more because you...
No. I think the plumber will make more because it's very much...
We got the point.
I think because...
I think we bit this horse.
No. I enjoyed this way too much.
I know.
And don't forget also that there's... People don't want to take the shitty jobs. Everybody wants to go to college and get the... And right now, you try to get a plumber. You remember how long it takes? You need to get an electrician. Real world is real world. And by the way, you know how I am right about this? There's an episode of South Park about it. If there's an episode of South Park about it, it means that it's godsend. And
so we want Leah to go into construction.
Yes. Yes.
I think that's a great...
Yes, she needs to learn how to lift heavy shit.
Well, she does lift heavy shit for the size. But I think, actually, we will need more homes. That's definitely good business to be in. There is something about it. I think there are those skills that either you're going to build the AI, you're going to train the AI, you're going to work in the AI building things. That's one good job for the future. Work in NVIDIA and the others on the GPUs. Gosh, that's needed. Chemistry. Chemistry is always going to be needed.
Yes, because you need to build bombs.
Because you need to build this GPUs on something. You need silicon. You need people that understand silicon.
That's physics.
Physics and, you know, yeah.
The chemistry is making meth. That's always necessary.
And you need to send people to... the moon to harvest materials from there.
That's actually the chemistry. The most important thing right now is making efficient fuels.
Yeah. So that's, I mean, go learn sciences. That's not going to be replaced by AI.
Yep.
And what else?
I think this is where we need to look at this as an opportunity, because when the newer languages came in development. Do you remember we were talking about the codeless and code-free?
Yeah.
We were touching this. It's an opportunity.
Absolutely, it's an opportunity. It's just so hard to imagine what will happen in 10 years when things develop so fast. So if you're thinking about what you need to have good skills in some areas. Engineering, is a good way
real
to
engineering
go.
When you say engineering, not software engineering, like
building stuff
is always an important thing, because this is the the idea of how to build a bridge is always, you'll always need to build a bridge. You always need to build a car.
Yeah. Electronics still needed.
Yeah. So I think there's a couple of jobs that are still safe. And I think this is where you also need to look at the financials. I think you sent me that daily about how shitty it is to be 33 these days.
That was really interesting. How I didn't realize that there is this 2-year cohort that of millennials that are now 33. It's the biggest cohort ever born in the US. Plus, there was like waves of immigration. I think Russia collapsed. It's like beginning of the 90s, right?
Yeah.
It's really interesting how this specific cohort generation of like small 2 years are really suffering going through the economy because of being the biggest. There are like 9 million of them.
So it's hard, it's very expensive to have a wedding if you're at that generation.
And now they don't bring up kids to the world. Yep. It's hard for them. They were also badly hit coming to college in 2008. When the big economy
issue happened,
and then pandemic happened for them when they were about to buy a new home, so they're like
continuously getting screwed.
They're struggling.
I think this is the main thing to understand. You need to understand if you do need to learn a skill, is you need to understand basic economics, and that goes back to statistics because you need to understand when the market is going against you. And it's not the complicated econometrics. It doesn't need, you don't need to be Kahneman. A lot of times you just need to take a look at the basics. When people buy pet rocks, you understand that there's an excess in the economy and that's going to go boom because that means that there's a bubble. And when people struggle hard, you understand that they will turn because the economy always does boom, bust, boom, bust, boom, bust. So this is like understanding the basics.
Finance is important.
Understanding how
economics, finance.
Understanding how money works is a very important element. Yeah. Because like you were talking about being a doctor or a lawyer. It used to be the jobs of every Jewish parent's dream.
I think every Jewish parent's dream should be just invest early in S&P 500 and forget about it. You'll be fine.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Or learn how to build shit. Like,
oh, in your point, like keep stocks of Microsoft for 40 years.
Yes. And understand how to seal the roof. Don't forget, because roofs will always leak.
That's my grandpa's business. He was always right. That's another thing. Going back to real estate, the rain is going to be there, maybe more of it, maybe less of it.
Yes.
And every 10 years, you're going to seal now your roof.
If the rain's going to be more, you know who you need to have? Somebody that fixed the drain.
Again, the real problems in life.
Yes.
Food and housing.
Yes.
So I hope I'm giving you some ideas of how to AI-proof your jobs. It's maybe if you are being driven out of the market at a certain point, just move to real estate.
Yes. But keep in mind that the support jobs that you were mentioning, those have moved to Manila and Mexico years ago. So
then now Manila not going to have business because instead of Manila, there's going to be ChatGPT type of thing instead.
Well, they can always sell Imelda Marcos's shoes again. If you remember that one.
Yeah. They can go to Cybill.
They can go to Cybill. Exactly. They'll do pig butchering.
Exactly.
That's always
they
fraud.
They already have the fraud, infrastructure.
Yes. Fraud, by the way, is always crime, always pays.
And that's what I'm scared of, that all those, outsource big farms that was used for customer service, they will become the ransomware.
And they'll use AI.
Actually, it's already,
they will use
why
AI.
Would you use them when you can have AI do the ransomware?
Exactly.
They're also coined operated even
correct.
More. So they'll be the first to use AI, they already do.
Exactly.
Awesome.
Cool. With that optimistic thought.
I hope that this was helpful. Tell us how you think the job market
will change.
Is going to evolve with AI. Thank you. The Didi and Lital Show is a weekly podcast. If you like our show, please rate and review us and share with your friends. We will see you next week. Thanks, Didi.
Thanks, Lital. And tell us how you celebrated St. Patty's.
Please do. Have a good one. I'm going down south. I'm going to have myself a time.